Hello everyone, here in this video I am going to explain one specific or important question which is related to symmetric matrix and skew symmetric matrix. The question is important from the examination point of view. Already in the previous video we have discussed that any square matrix, maybe of 1 by 1, maybe of 2 by 2, 3 by 3, whatever may be the square matrix of order, any square matrix can be expressed as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. আমি যদি যিকোনো square matrix consider করো, that matrix is uniquely expressed as a sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. আমি যিকোনো square matrix of এটা symmetric আৰু এটা skew symmetric matrix or addition হিচাপে express কৰিব পাৰো. And in the previous video we have got that expression actually. What is the expression? We know that A plus A transpose as a matrix R to R transpose or addition to is always known as symmetric. This one is symmetric. And A minus A transpose, this expression is always skew symmetric. This no. Now, if we add sum of the two matrix is again a matrix and define between two matrix itself is a matrix. A to A matrix or A matrix, two matrices we have considered. Let us add them. What we have got? Plus A transpose, minus A transpose, it will be cancelled. Then A plus A will be twice A. As equality sign is there, whatever may be the there on the right hand side is exactly, it should be equal with the expression which lies on the left hand side. But the right hand side, what we have got twice A. We know that twice A can never be equal with A. So to as equality sign is there, we have to multiply it by half so that it will be equal with A. That's why we will try to multiply the whole expression by half. Then it will be exactly equal with A. Okay? Now just try to multiply. Okay? Now we try to multiply this expression as half of A plus A transpose plus half of A minus A transpose. It is known to us, if we multiply matrix by scalar quantity, its property will remain same. This one is symmetric. Half A multiply for a pasal is symmetric property. Symmetric. Here also, A minus A transpose is too symmetric. After multiplying it by scalar quantity half, its property will remain same. That means, again, it will be a skew symmetric matrix. তাহলে আমি গম পালো এটা matrix of symmetric আর এটা skew symmetric matrix sort addition হিসাবে express করিবার ভাবে we will try to apply that properties or steps. যিকোনো matrix এটা দিয়া থাকিলে তাক যদি skew symmetric আর symmetric matrix or addition হিসাবে express করিব দিয়ে তেতিয়া আমি কি করি first of all we'll try to find out its transpose. Then we'll try to find out the value of A plus A transpose and A minus A transpose. We'll multiply each by half. Then we'll add them. After adding this one expression, if we get A, then we can easily say that the matrix A can be expressed as sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. This part is symmetric matrix and this one is skew symmetric matrix. This is the property we should remember. So I have written here the property is like that, half of A plus A transpose plus half of A minus A transpose. This is the property. Okay, we should remember this one. Okay, we should remember this one. So, here what is the matrix is given to us? The matrix which is given to us is B. So, express the matrix B as a sum of symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. The question will be given to us like that. So, I mean, the key coding, obviously, the given matrix is B. It is already given. So, we'll try to write down. Given. B is given to us. What is the matrix B? B is 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1, 3, 4 1 minus 2 minus 3. It's my request only just go through the skew. So many different questions are available with us. No need to find out the answer of each and every question. You will get the, if you will get the idea about this one. এটা কোয়েশ্চন করলে তুমি কোয়েশ্চনটো ভালকে এবাৰ মন কৰা কিবিলাক ষ্টেপ আমি ফলো কৰো হুইচ আৰ দ্য মোষ্ট ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট ষ্টেপছ টু বি ৰিমেম্বাৰ টু এক্সপ্ৰেছ এ মেট্ৰিক্স এজ এ সাম অফ সিমেট্ৰিক এণ্ড স্কিউ সিমেট্ৰিক মেট্ৰিক্স ওকে সো দিছ ইজ দ্য গিভেন মেট্ৰিক্স দেয়াৰফোর উইল ট্ৰাই টু ফাইণ্ড আউট ৱাট উইল ট্ৰাই টু ফাইণ্ড আউট বি ট্ৰান্সপোজ বিকজ টু এক্সপ্ৰেছ এনি মেট্ৰিক্স এজ সাম অফ সিমেট্ৰিক এণ্ড স্কিউ সিমেট্ৰিক মেট্ৰিক্স উই হ্যাভ টু ইউজ এ ট্ৰান্সপোজ হিয়াৰ উইল ট্ৰাই টু ফাইণ্ড আউট বি ট্ৰান্সপোজ what is the matrix B transpose? So row will become column and column will converted to row. What is the first row? 2 minus 2 minus 4. 2 minus 2 minus 4. Second row it will be minus 1, 3, 4. What is the third row? 1 minus 2 minus 3. So this is the matrix B. Now what we do? This part is symmetric and this part is symmetric. We will consider this two different. Let P is equal to half of B plus B transpose. We don't know P is symmetric or not, but it's known to us that P is always symmetric because this one is symmetric. After multiplying it by half, it will become symmetric once again. It will be unknown. In the examination, we have to show that. Yes, this matrix. We have to give that confirmation that the matrix is symmetric. First of all, we have to find out the value of B plus B transpose. B is of 3 by 3, B transpose is also 3 by 3. Again, after adding these two matrix, you will get the matrix of whatever 3 by 3. Thus, add them. At least corresponding elements should be added. 2 plus 2, 4. Minus 2, minus 1 equal to minus 3. Minus 3. Okay? Plus 4, minus 4 plus 1 equal to be minus 3. Minus 1, minus 2 equal to be minus 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. And 4 minus 3 equal to be 2. 1 minus 4 equal to be minus 3. Correct? Minus 2 plus 4 equal to be 2. And minus 3 equal to be minus 6. Listen, half is a scalar quantity. If you observe carefully, here you have got this matrix is symmetric. Do you know why? The diagonally symmetrical. They're diagonally symmetrical. So minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, 2. Diagonal is symmetrical. If for relation or if for corresponding element, exactly same way. So I mean, symmetric will become a question. But then also we have to prove it. Just multiply by half. Are we symmetric or can half multiply by the property will remain same? So half a multiply by 1 of 2, it will be minus 3 by 2, it will be minus 3 by 2, it will be minus 3 by 2, minus 3 by 2, 3, 1, 1, minus 3. Okay, we have got this one. So this one is P. P is means what? P is a matrix, which is an expression of half of P plus B transpose. Now we have to put that P is symmetric. Now, to take a symmetric and isosymmetric property, you have to find out transpose only. So let P transpose. Try to transpose it. Row will become column and column will become row. So it will be 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2. First row will be converted to first column. Then second row will be converted to second column. Minus 3 by 2, 3, 1. Then it will be minus 3 by 2, 1. Minus 3. What you have got? P is nothing but the same matrix. After having the transpose, you have got the same matrix. Therefore, P is equal to half of B plus B transpose is what? Symmetric. We can easily prove that. I mean, P number 0 expression considered for symmetric. P will be that is nothing but a symmetric matrix. We have that confirmation. Now, we will try to consider this part and we have to prove that this expression is too symmetric. Okay, in the same way, let us consider, but you have to remember P. So I have written somewhere, suppose. So what is P? I have written it here. For a further use, we'll consider this one as P, suppose. This one I use for both you like it on the. So now let us consider this one as Q. This is equal to what? B minus B transpose. Now we try to find out the value B minus B transpose means you have to just subtract or find the difference of the corresponding elements. 2 minus 2 will become 0, minus 2 plus 1 it will be minus 1, minus 4 minus 1 it will be minus 5. Okay, then the minus 1 plus 2 it will be plus 1, 3 minus 3 it will become 0, 4 minus 3 it will be 6, 1, 5 it will be minus 2 minus 4 it will be minus 6 and minus 3 it will be 0. So from the observation here also you have come to know that the diagonal elements are 0 first property to be symmetric and they are diagonally symmetrical no doubt but they are defined by the sign minus 1 plus 1 minus 5 plus 5 plus 6 minus 6. So 6 to symmetric will become 5 also. Then also we have to simplify it. So 0 it will be minus half then it will be minus 5 by 2. Okay? Then half 0 it will be 3. It will be 5 by 2, it will be minus 3, or it will be what? 0. Okay? Then we will try to prove it that Q is too symmetric. I mean, too symmetric will be proved for it. So, Okay, well, I will write it down. I will write it down here. It will be better for us. So now, Q transpose. To be symmetric or skew symmetric, you will find the transpose. Just transpose it, you will get 0 minus half minus 5 by 2. Half 0, half 0 it will be 3, or 5 by 2 minus 3 will become 0. Okay? Just try to simplify. Just take it is known to us, Q is skew symmetric. Skew symmetric means Q transpose equal to minus Q power like you. Then minus the common. Just take it minus common. Common and the power do. 0 power, it power half, it will become 5 by 2. It will become minus half, it will become 0 minus 3. Minus 5 by 2, 3, then it will become 0. What you have done? Is it Q? This is the Q. Are they same? Just try to compare. You have got what? Minus sign is already there, and this expression is nothing but the matrix Q. That means what you have got actually? Q transpose equal to minus 2. Therefore, Q is what? S. Q transpose equal to minus Q. Therefore, Q is equal to half of B minus B transpose is skew symmetric. We have got it. We have given the confirmation in the exam that the matrices that we have considered, one is P and R is Q, are symmetric and skew symmetric respectively. Now we try to add these two matrices. Either symmetric or skew symmetric, but zeta B or B transpose will be born always. B matrix to use for born always. The matrix can be added. Kumita either symmetric or the skew symmetric. And try to simplify. Let's see what you will get. So what do we do now? So after having this one, we will try to add P and Q. Okay. Now, P plus Q. Correct? P plus Q means? What is the value of P here? 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2. It will be minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2. 3, 1, 1 minus 3. This one is P. Okay. Then plus Q. 0, half, 5 by 2. Minus half, 0, minus 3, minus 5 by 2. 0. Okay, what we have done actually here, P is symmetric and Q is skew symmetric, already we have mentioned there. Now we have added one symmetric and one skew symmetric matrix, which are nothing but the expression of P and P transpose. Let's see what it is. I mean, keep on my personal statement. So just write here then, 2 plus 0 it will be 2, minus 3 by 2, minus 1 it will be minus 2. And it will be what? Minus 3, it will be minus 4. Okay, try to simplify. Minus 3 by 2, it will be minus 1, 3, 4. Okay, then it will be 1, it will be minus 2, and it will be minus 3. Just go through the question once again. In the given question, what it is there? What is given? B is equal to what? B is given 2 minus 2 minus 4. Minus 1, 3, 4. 1 minus 2 minus 3. Are the same? Just try to compare. Exactly. We have got the same matrix. It's nothing but B. That means B is what? B is the sum of two matrix, no doubt. But out of these two matrix, P is what? Symmetric and Q is skew symmetric. Hence, sure. I mean, B number matrix is the matrix right? It's the express for this. Therefore, or you can say that, therefore, B can be expressed. As the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. In this way, you have to keep that conclusion. So I hope you have got the steps which are required to prove that a matrix is a sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. Thank you so much for watching the video. Thank you so much.